After a few minutes, he edges out of his hiding place, shivering. He crawls on his knees along the side of the podium, then pushes his face slowly closer to the front corner of it to peer in fearful anguish around the angle of splintery wood. No human being is in sight. A fitful wind blows dust and tumbleweed down the empty hallway, past the unoccupied podiums, in a monochrome befitting an abandoned saloon bar in a deserted town in a Western movie. At the far end of the hallway, the club's main double doors swing towards each other by themselves, then slam dead shut with a sliding of bolts. Hunched on the floor like a bug, Shigem listens hard for a full minute, but can hear nothing through the sound of the desert breeze. He gets to his feet, feels the blade cuts on the back of his neck, inspects the blood on his fingers, and wipes it off on the side of the podium. He tiptoes through an archway into the deserted main room of the club. Here, everything is still, except for the bobbing reflections from a huge mirrored disco ball suspended from high rafters above the center of the dance floor, which turns in the stillness. He steps across the floor, his gaze burrowing into all the dark corners of the room, and then he hears it. From somewhere, buried in the bowels of this sprawling club, Kruger's time-biding chuckle chugs softly in the shadows, as if promising him a dark game with pale ropes in a night maze forest.